How are you?
I'm good. How are
you? Nice to see you.
You too. You look amazing.
Thanks so much for saying.
Jesus, this is... Can you tell us about the fit?
Of course. So this is made by OTT.
Okay.
And it is a bit OTT, to be honest. It's full of colour. I love colour so much. They cut up a bunch of old things that they've previously made, and they like refashion them into new stuff. And I love it. I'm such a fan of anything sustainable fashion, and I'm feeling fun.
Feeling sexy and free?
I would say that. I would say both those things are true.
So tell me about your nominations tonight, because it's actually interesting that you bring up this kind of arrangement of your clothing,
oh,
right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Because you're nominated in that category.
That's it.
So I want to hear about what that process looks like for you, because I feel like that might be an esoteric one for people at home of like what that legwork looks like.
What is that? Yeah.
What?
So, an arrangement is like the reassembly of materials. So what I did this year was with some friends of mine, Sage, we took a really old song called In the Wee Small Hours of the Morning. Do you know that song?
I do.
Old jazz tune.
Beautiful.
And we kind of took it to pieces and put it back together again. And the way in which we did that, for whatever reason, was saluted by the Grammys, which is really an honor. And it's a total delight to be here. It really is.
So what does it look like in your brain, or sound like, or feel like when you're presented with this material? What do you reach for first? What instrument do you reach for first? Mm. What's that, I guess, the step-by-step of getting that project done?
Yeah, it depends on the song.
Mm-hmm.
Depends on what you need. But for this one, it's all voices, which is gorgeous. And I love the voice. I think voice is the most important instrument, because we all have one. They're all different. And it's something so human about it. So I've always been a fan of layering multiple voices together to hit chords. You know chords, right?
I know chords. We know chords.
Come on, everyone knows chords. And just the warmth and the... It's like painting a picture with a ever-changing paintbrush. You know, you get to design the contour, the arc, the line of your story.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really, really a pleasure to do that.
So I've seen you on TikTok out there playing instruments I didn't even know existed.
Oh.
So I want to know, from your perspective, what do you think the next frontier is for music? It could be for music production, for elements that we'll be seeing more in music, for inspiration, truly anything.
I think we're about to see like a massive surge of collaboration because the world is becoming kind of smaller and smaller, and people are taking more and more risks, which I love, and I feel like I've always been a bit like that, but now I'm looking around and seeing people surprise each other, which is gorgeous. And I'd also say that one of the big questions right now, I think, is how AI is going to interface with music.
Mm.
There are inherent challenges, but also like thrilling ideas and new materials that are being made available to all of us to play with. So I think in those two spaces, I'm excited to see like a surge of curiosity, I suppose. And I'm just hopeful that AI is taken for what it is, which is like a really kind of deeply powerful but really exciting way of revolutionizing how we think about sound and collision. It's like, it's like colliding things together. It helps us be alchemists in a more interesting way.
100%. You're like cooking up potions in the lab.
Storms, yeah. Cooking up storms, yeah.
So one last question for you, because you brought up collaborations. What is your secret to working with other artists? Because I think that's such an interesting thing, to not only befriend someone, become personable, and have that relationship with them to get to the good stuff, but then also you're working. And you want to hopefully continue to work with them.
Yeah, so it's an interesting dynamic. I think the biggest thing is just not to take yourself too seriously.
Mm.
Because it's easy to be like, I'm Jacob, I'm really important. My taste goes, you know, it's like, no one knows what's going on, no one. And everyone who steps into a studio, there's an amount, or there should be an amount of like, I wonder what's going to happen. So I think over the years, I've become like less certain about my taste and more open. And I think that's merited more interesting results than me going and being like, I know exactly what I'm going to get, and then missing the magic on either side, if that makes sense, you know?
Well, we appreciate the curiosity.
Thank you.
It shows. I feel like you are always looking for the next thing, so thank you so much for everything you're adding
you're
to
welcome.
This industry.
No worries, absolutely.
Have a great time tonight. Thank you for stopping by.
Thanks for your lovely
Best
questions.
Best of luck. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks a lot.